So I now want to take now these ideas and take them into growth of cities and some of the implications. It's the same kind of ideas. You have all this stuff coming in, both the physical aspects, resources, energy, and so forth, but you're also creating and so on. So this, I'm not going to go into any details, but that drives, that goes into maintaining the city, keeping the streets up and the pipes and so on, and then growing it. So that's just a very simplistic way of talking about it. We can make this quite fancy and sexy. And you remember, when we took that equation, that's what it gave for biology. This is what it gives for cities, driven by superlinear behavior coming from the social network, which invokes this continuous positive feedback mechanism of social interactions. And I've just done a cartoon version, and you can see this exponential growth, which is what we see. So that's great. This whole thing is consistent. The theory is nice. But it has a dire consequence. The dire consequence is that what it says is that the system cannot continue. It must collapse at some stage. And that's what that dotted line is, and that tells you how it collapses. That's very bad. We want to avoid that. And the way we have avoided it is to recognize that when you grow like this, you are growing within some paradigm, some innovative paradigm. So just, I'm going to talk about the big picture, about the economy rather than specific cities, but I won't have time to talk about that, so let me talk in the bigger picture. So you discover iron, whenever it was, 20,000 years ago, or 10,000 years ago. You discover iron. That changes things. That changes a whole bunch of things. But more recently, you discover coal. Starts the Industrial Revolution, and even more recently, we invent computers. Changes. Discover IT. So each one of those major innovations, so to speak, resets the clock. So it tells you how you can avoid collapse. You're going along this curve, life is getting faster, and you would collapse. So somewhere along there, you better reset the clock by inventing computers or whatever. And that means that you would start again and go on. Of course, you would eventually collapse for the same reason. So you better make another innovation, a new innovation. And so it goes. You have to keep going. So there's a kind of theory. If you want to have open-ended growth, which is what we have demanded, then you have to be continuously on innovation cycles, which you're familiar with. You have to be resetting the clock or reinventing yourself in some way. But there's another catch. The catch is that not only as you go along one of these curves and you're getting bigger, is life getting faster, but the time between those innovations is getting shorter, is what the theory says. So something that might have taken 100 years to develop 500 years ago, now only takes 15 years. And the next innovation should take less than 15 years, maybe 10 or 12 years. So what it says is if we want to continue on this trajectory, and we believe this speculation from this, that we have to have in the next 15 to 20 years another major innovation comparable to the IT revolution if we're going to maintain this open-ended growth. So that's the idea. And I just showed this, not me, I have no idea who this person is, but I found this on the web because it illustrates it, and it's a similar thing. And I don't know where you did it before. I did it before my work. But and here's another version of it. This is the innovation. Innovation, and what you see,
major innovation. I'm sorry, I'm going to have to go here. This is time to the next sort of life. So look up here. Life took several billion years to evolve, and it happened several billion years ago. That's up here. Down here, this happened just recently. Hardly any time, and it took a very short time to develop. So you have this continually piling up, and the theory predicts that red line.
And I'm not going to go into it, but there it is. So, and this is actually applied to specific cities. I don't have time to go into it other than the right hand side, that's New York City. That's analyzing the growth of New York City. And just to give you a sense, very quickly, is that if you look at the time between these various little perceived bumps in it, these little scalloped events,
then they're supposed to be getting closer, and you can see, as you look, they are indeed,
there's evidence that they're getting, these oscillations are getting closer and closer. Okay.